Hi guys, for me it's not particularly easy make this video because my English is enough but not perfect. And I won't try to understand that you understand the better possible about the bias and the EQ. And the cassette, the right recording and the right playing. These are the four type cassette: normal, chrome, position 1, 2, 3, and 4. We have inscription. It's possible. No, not focus. Okay. Normal bias, high bias, metal bias, and this is today's the ferrochrome cassette, type 3 ferrochrome or type 1 normal. The problem is on the ferrochrome, the cassette of today. The bias is an electromagnet signal we can't hear because it's a very high frequency, and this signal is very important to make a good recording. A good correct bias makes a better recording. The type 1 cassette needs a normal bias, a signal not much high. It's the parameter of normal bias. The type 2 needs more bias than type 1, and we say high bias. Type 4, metal bias. The bias needs more high than type 2 because it's more difficult to magnetize in correct way this type of tape, and also delete this type of tape. But the problem is the type 3, because we have, I show you again, type 3 ferrochrome or type 1. How it's possible? Okay, let's see. Type 1 has nothing, only the clip to handle it, the tape. Okay, this is for the automatic recognition of tape. Type 2 has a second. You see, the first is to handle it, and the second is for chrome position. Look the difference. Okay, it's a second knob. Type 4 has this too, but also this at the center. This is type 4. And type 3? Nothing. Like the type 1. Why? Why? What means this? The type 3 cassette had not a big success. This was produced only for a little period. And it is a combination of type 1 and type 2. So not every deck was ready to record on type 3 cassette. And to make this cassette much compatible possible with every deck, there were this compromise. If you can't record on correct type 3 position, this cassette can be recorded also on type 1 position. Why? Why this? Because on this cassette, normal bias is enough. We see. Type 1 and type 3 need normal bias. So, when I put this with normal bias, it's possible record correct this cassette, but not perfectly correct, because this type 3 ferrochrome position asks another parameter, the EQ, the equalization, and the 120 EQ is microseconds. It's only for type 1. Type 2, 3 and 4 needs 70 EQ, microseconds EQ. What happens if I have a deck with ferrochrome position? This will be recorded with normal bias and 70 microsecond EQ. If I have not a deck with ferrochrome position, but a deck with type 1, type 2, type 4, and the selector of EQ, I put type 1 normal bias 70 microseconds. What happens if I don't have the possibility of switching 70 microsecond and 120 microsecond? A not perfect recording on this cassette, because I will record maybe on normal bias 120, the parameter of type 1. You see, type 1. The bias is important only in recording mode. The microseconds, it's important in record and play. What means? If I record on normal bias 70 microseconds, when I play, I need 70 microseconds. Bias, there is not. Bias, only when I record. In play, bias is off. So, in play, if I record on 70 microseconds, I need play in 70 microseconds. If I record in 120 microseconds, I need the play in 120 microseconds. What happens if I record this on type 1 normal? When I play in any deck, I need put on type 1. If I record with ferrochrome position is 70 microseconds, I need play on 70 microseconds. If I have only type 1, 2 and 4, I need type 2, because type 2 is 70 microseconds. If I record with type 1 normal bias 70 microseconds, for example Nakamichi, I need to play on 70 microseconds, because the bias works only in recording mode, not in play mode. At the EQ I record, at that EQ I need play. If, for example, I have a deck with only type 1 and type 2 position, I need record. Here I say with the normal bias, because when I record, the bias is most important than EQ. So if I don't have the type 3 position, I need recording type 1, but type 1 is 120 microseconds, and I need play in 120 microseconds. An example. Nakamichi, for example, has not the type 3 position, has type 1, type 2, and type 4, but has the EQ button, which is the best bias, and the bias is important for the recording, for the type 3, the one type 1 bias, but 70 microsecond. If I record with the normal bias and 70 microseconds, I need play in 70 microseconds. Which is the position in play of 70 microseconds? The type 2, chrome position. So, if I record the ferrochrome position here, I record with type 1 and 70, but I need the play in type 2, because in play I have 70 microseconds. If I play the cassette recorded on Nakamichi here on JVC, I need play in type 2 position, because here is 70 microseconds. If I record the type 3 here on normal position, I need play here on 120 microseconds and normal position. So, I repeat, the bias works only in recording mode. And it's important the correct bias. Type 1 and type 3 normal bias, high bias for type 2, metal bias for type 4. But if I record on 70 microseconds, I need the play in 70 microseconds. If I record on 120 microseconds, I need play in 120 microseconds. When I record here, type 1, 70 microseconds, I need the play in type 1, 70 microseconds. But here, the 70 microseconds, it's only this position. So I need the play the ferrochrome cassette on type 2 position if I record on Nakamichi. But if I record here, because I need the normal bias for record here, I need the play on Nakamichi at 120 microseconds. If I record here on ferrochrome position, the right position, I need the play on 70 microseconds. Type 2 70 or type 2 of a boombox. I understand it's not easy, but this cassette has normal bias 70 microseconds. It's a mix ferrochrome of type 1 and type 2. If I record with 70 microseconds, I need play on 70 microseconds. If I record on normal position, I need play in normal position. If I record in ferrochrome position or 70 microseconds, I need play in type 2 or type 3 position, because the bias works only in recording, and the best bias for every tape makes a better recording. This works on record and play. If I record in 120, I need the play in 120. If I record in 70, I need the play in 70. And that's why in the video you will see this cassette record on JVC boombox, play at 120 microseconds. Recorded on other deck, play in 70 microseconds. Sorry, I hope that it's clear. For any question, write in the comments below. Okay, let's calibrate the Nakamichi. The position is position one, and the EQ is 70 microseconds. The level is okay. Bias, very high bias. Level? Azimut. Azimut, ok. Scalibrating. Ok, let's calibrate the Akai. Akai has the ferrochrome position. Ferrochrome. This is type 1, type 2 and type 3 ferrochrome position. The calibration is for level. Ok, we see. Ok. Tono. Now difference. Ah. It's noisy. Okay, look. Okay, between source and tape it's perfectly, but I hear noise. Okay, let's record.
Thank you.